How's it going, guys? This is the big one. It is the review for Star Wars Battlefront, and I am reviewing it on Xbox One. Now, unfortunately, I'm not important enough yet, like all the other YouTubers, to get an early review copy of the game. So what I've done, I've gone on to EA Access, and I've managed to get 10 full hours of this game under my belt. So I'm ready for my review. So let's start it. So here we go, we're starting the review in the same way that the game starts. This is the game installation. Now, normally these game installation sections on the Xbox One are a little bit dull. Most games will only give you the intro movie, or they might give you the campaign, which obviously Battlefront doesn't have. But what they've done here, they've given you this little section on Hoth, and they give you control of Darth Vader, and you get to go around with your lightsaber, basically tearing rebels up. This is a really good introduction. You're waiting for the game to install, you're a little bit impatient, and then they just go, here you go, here's Darth Vader, go nuts. And it's basically a horde mode where the rebels keep coming at you and you have to kill as many of them as you can. And I thought this was a great way, while I was waiting for the game to install, it was a great way to build the hype going into the game. I thought this was great. Great start.
Feel the power of the dark side.
So, after the game is installed and you've killed no doubt hundreds of rebels as Darth Vader, you go into the main menu. I like the main menu. It's very crisp, it's very clear, and it's very simple to use. The first thing that the game will ask you to do, you don't have to do it, but it asks you if you want to do a tutorial. Now, if you played the beta, I wouldn't bother personally. It's very simple. It literally takes between 2 and 3 minutes, and it just shows you how to shoot the gun, how to change view, how to use your special power-ups. It's very simple. It's very basic. I would say even if you've played any other first-person shooter, you'll have a general gist of how to understand the game. So personally, I don't think the tutorial is massively necessary, but it's a nice little feature to have.
What was that? Move out! Move out!
Anyway, that's enough about tutorials and game installation sections. Let's get into it. Star Wars Battlefront, is it any good? We'll start off where we always do. Let's look at the graphics. So I'm kicking things off here by starting at Endor, and as you can see here, even on the Xbox One, this game looks stunning. You can see here all the leaves moving aside for you as you walk through them. It's a nice little touch, and the game looks stunning. It looks absolutely gorgeous. Moving on to the big fat elephant in the room, and it's the resolution. It looks to me like the Xbox One version of the game is operating around the 720p mark, which is a little bit disappointing for Xbox fans. On PlayStation 4, we are expecting at least a 900p, possibly a 1080p, so that's a little bit disappointing for the Xbox crowd. But you've got 60 frames per second, it is absolutely buttery smooth, and at the end of the day, regardless of resolution, pushing aside that little P number for a moment, just looking at the game, as you can see, it looks fantastic. Moving on to sound, and while there may be a question mark about the resolution of the game, there are absolutely no questions about how good the sound is. Seriously. Listen to some of this.
Watch for homing missiles.
I'm going down! Seriously, how good is that sound? Every single decibel of sound in this game is immaculate. They've got everything from John Williams' score all the way through to the sounds of the blasters and the ships. Everything is accurately recreated to make you feel like you're in the Star Wars universe. The sound is absolutely fantastic. If there is one minor minor negative when it comes to the sound. I suppose it comes down to the voices. They haven't managed to get the actual actors like Harrison Ford and James Earl Jones, so they've used other actors to try and imitate their voices, and they're not massively accurate. They're decent impressions, you know, they'll do, but they're not fantastic. They're not up to the level of the rest of the sound work. Now, the voices don't play a major part. A character will throw out a taunt every now and then, or Darth Vader will talk about the dark side, something like that. So it's not a major issue. It's literally a little nitpick, and it doesn't stop the sound work by DICE in this game being fantastic. Next up is arguably the most important aspect when it comes to the game, and that is the gameplay. Now, as you can see here, there are 9 different options for what you can play. You've got things like Fighter Squadron, Walker Assault, Drop Zone, Hero Hunt. What I'll say is, I've pumped quite a bit of time into each of these game modes, and you've got some winners and you've got some losers when it comes to this. Now, personally, I'm a big fan of Walker Assault, which is what we saw in the beta as well. I just love it. I love the massive aspect to it, the grand scale of it, of there being AT-ATs, AT-STs. It's a proper battle. It's like nothing you've seen before in a video game. I love that. Also, I'm a massive, massive fan of Fighter Squadron. This is amazing. It's literally dogfighting. You're in the air, you've got an X-Wing, an A-Wing, or you can go over to the dark side and you can get in a TIE fighter, and it's just, oh, you're in the air, you're blasting the shit out of each other. It's literally mayhem. Like I've said before, you've got other things like Blast, which is literally just Team Deathmatch. Another interesting one, I suppose, that's worth mentioning is Hero Hunt, which is basically you have 5 or 6 players in a match. One of you will start out as one of the heroes, like Luke Skywalker, for example. And the other guys, who will be stormtroopers, have to kill him. Whoever kills him then takes over as a hero, but not necessarily as Luke Skywalker. You might become Princess Leia or Han Solo. And then it repeats, and then everybody tries to kill him. And it ultimately comes down to who has got the most kills at the end of the game. It's quite interesting. It's a different twist on things, and even though I'm not massively good at it, I'm still adjusting, you know, after 10 hours of play. I'm not perfect with all the characters, but it's really fun gameplay.
Lucky shot. I don't think so.
Now, I can't talk you through all of the game modes, guys, otherwise this review will be about 3 hours long, but I'll save my last little mention for Heroes versus Villains. This is a very interesting game mode. To put it simply, as you can see here, you'll have Boba Fett, the Emperor, and Darth Vader on one side, and then on the other side you'll have Leia, Luke Skywalker, and Han Solo. And there's a couple of Rebels and Stormtroopers sprinkled about there as well, just to help out, but it's literally throwing all these heroes, all these major heroes and all these major villains into a pot and getting them to fight each other. This is the stuff that Star Wars fanboys were dreaming of. This is a very interesting mode. It's a different mode. It's a bit chaotic, but in a good way. The only negative aspect, again, that I've got with this mode is that when playing as the Emperor in particular, his Force Lightning doesn't feel it doesn't feel as powerful as it should. Like taking Destiny as an example, where you can now use Force Lightning, inverted commas, in Destiny as one of the characters. In that, it feels powerful, it feels epic. Playing as the Emperor, it doesn't feel quite as powerful. It feels a little like a little bit of a trickle of electricity. I mean, it does the job. If you line somebody up in your sights and you electrocute them, they die fairly quickly, but it doesn't feel as epic and as powerful as it does in the films. You don't feel the force feedback in the control pad as much as you should, but that's just a little niggle. This mode is a lot of fun. I can't finish talking about the gameplay, guys, without talking about the missions. Obviously, you've got the multiplayer aspect, but you've also got the missions aspect, where you've got the option of battles, and you've got the options of survival, where you take on either friends or AI. And the battles is... they're pretty much the same thing, except with the battles, you can play as the heroes. You can play as Han Solo, you can play as Luke, whoever you want to. Now, this mode can't be ignored, guys. It's a really good addition to the package for me. It's effectively the only single-player aspect to the game, but also it's got split-screen capabilities, so you can get some of your friends around, you can play split-screen. It's actually a lot of fun, and for me, there weren't really any hiccups when it came to performance with the split-screen either, so this is a viable option. It's a lot of fun. Now, EA and DICE, they could have gone down a similar route to games like Titanfall, where the game was multiplayer only. There was no single-player aspect to it. So at least with this mode, if you don't fancy going online and getting destroyed by everyone, if you just fancy getting a blaster out, shooting some stormtroopers, this is a good mode for that. If you just want to chill out, spend a bit of time, kill some people from the Empire, or kill some rebels if you're feeling like on the dark side, this is a good mode for that. It's a good addition to the package. And so, guys, we come down to the verdict. Now, for me, everybody, for some reason, is going to compare this game to Battlefield. Now, for me, yeah, it's made by DICE, and there are a lot of similarities to Battlefield, I suppose, but it's much, much more than just a reskin. You can tell that the guys who've worked on this game love Star Wars. They've painstakingly gone over all the little details, and they've made this a game for Star Wars fans. Even if you're not a Star Wars fan, you are going to enjoy the gameplay here. It's fairly simple, fairly easy to understand, easy to grasp, but you've got so many options, so many different game modes. The shooting is good, the guns feel meaty, there's an easy learning curve, it's not too difficult, so it's easy to get into, and most importantly, it is loads of fun. Absolutely loads of fun. I've had more fun in 10 hours with this game than I have in 20 or 30 hours playing different games. The game is perfectly balanced. I know that there were some balancing issues when it came to the beta, but they've all been fixed. The game now runs a lot more fairly for people. Also, you're getting a lot of value for money here. There's loads of different maps, loads of different characters, loads of things to unlock. I think a lot of people were worried that because it's EA, they were going to lock a lot of content behind some sort of paywall or season pass. Now, there is a season pass, which is going to have more maps and whatnot, but there's plenty here. Straight out of the gates, there's loads to get on with, loads of different game modes, loads to see. This game is superb. So when it comes to the score, now I personally like Star Wars. I'm a fan of Star Wars. I'm not a massive fan. I'm not one of these guys with encyclopedic knowledge of everything, but I enjoy the films and I'm definitely looking forward to Episode 7. Now, if you're a massive, massive Star Wars fan, I can't see you giving this game anything less than 10 out of 10. For me, I'm not happy with the fact that there isn't some sort of more substantial single-player element to it. That's a big miss for me. But as far as multiplayer goes, this is a fantastic multiplayer game. It's not perfect. There are a couple of little niggles here and there. But for me, it is a rock-solid 9 out of 10 and easily one of the best shooters of the year. Superb visual and audio presentation. Fantastically fun gameplay is only dragged down by the lack of a slightly more substantial single-player element. So there we go, guys, that's the review. Give me a like, subscribe to the channel, and I will do my best to keep the reviews coming. If you've got this game on pre-order, do not cancel it. You are in for a treat. And I will catch you next time.